Sometimes I might just actually decide to play, to hold the note down while I play some others. If I do that, typically what I'm going to do is hold down the start note, that's the E, that's the button three in the outside row, and just keep it held down no matter what. So it sounds like this. So, for the parts of the phrase where it seems sensible, I probably overdid it in that rendition, but quite often you can hold it down for a little short phrase. And, all right, so say it changes direction from E to C or to D occasionally as it goes from push to pull, but it doesn't really matter. It's so quick you won't notice anyway. It still sounds pretty reasonable, I think. So I'm holding that button down almost as a drone with my first finger and playing the tune with my second and third fingers. Sounds better at speed, to be honest, than it does slow, because at speed you can't tell what's going on. Other thing to mention, probably last thing to mention, I think, is the sometimes on the bass runs, instead of going bass chord, sometimes I'll just play the chord and hold it. Again, similar idea, you hold it no matter what. Certainly for the E minor and the B minor sections. And the only real thing I would say is that if you're playing on the push, I tend to just drop the chord out when I'm tempted to pull the chord. So that bit where it goes, instead of trying to hold the B chord all the way through, I just try and play the chord only when I'm pushing, so it sounds like. So it's held all the way down during that phrase. Again, held down all the way. Held down all the way through that phrase, even though it's in and out a lot, because it's on the C chord. Obviously the chord's the same, so I can do that. And the last phrase, because it's all on the push, I'm playing, I'm just playing the chord only when I'm pushing and not when I'm pulling on that phrase. Other thing I'd say with that phrase is I did say it could be played as D, it could equally well be played as B minor. So the whole thing sounds, the whole thing with that chord, playing with chords and no basses, sounds a bit like this. Okay, jolly good. One more thing to mention, I guess, if we're playing just chords, is the art of putting a pulse into the playing. If you're playing with bass and chords, that puts a pretty strong rhythm into a tune. But if you're just playing with chords, it's actually fairly hard to keep the same level of danceability into it. In other words, to actually show the dancers where the music is going, where it's stopping and where it's starting. So you have to put that in basically by putting a little pulse into the bellows. So instead of playing a straight bass chord like that, you put a little bit of a pulse into it like this. That's just done through bellows control. It's just a little bit of a little twitch of the left arm as you're pulling it out. Or you can do it by jerking the bellows downwards like that. Okay, to get the same effect. And that adds so much to the rhythm of that music when you're actually no longer playing the main bass chord. So it sounds like this. Okay, so I'll play the whole thing through again now slowly just to finish off. Good luck, and I look forward to seeing some of your submissions.